We wanted to dedicate this symposium to greenwashing because we do believe that there is a big, important gap between the seriousness and magnitude of the problem and the awareness.
In order to avoid the risk of, or at least minimize the risk of greenwashing, first of all, common definitions. Second, transparency. Third, the international comparability of taxonomies, of standards. Greenwashing is a big risk.
We have 3 years to go. In 3 years, we need to have governments, so it is an institutional issue. This cannot be dealt on a private basis.
We cannot reach the climate neutrality goal without a real circular economy model. And with the new action plan, Europe wants to concentrate not only to the final step of a product, but on the eco-design of products, in order to have products that are more sustainable. I worry about the fact that we won't have just to replace plastics without having a clear picture of the environmental effects of the alternative materials.
There are many false or deceptive claims, many fake news, which lead, first of all, consumers, all of us, when we enter a commercial store. But it also misleads the investors.
The overall conclusion of the sweep, member state authorities, in 42% of the cases, they signaled the website should go for a further investigation because they had reasons to believe that the claim was either false or deceptive and could therefore potentially amount to an unfair commercial practices under the Unfair Commercial Practices Directive.
We expect companies and brands to provide us with sustainable products, but even more important, we are really asking for being educated on how to purchase and use the product we buy and how to spot and detect what is the real green purpose brand or company or what is just greenwashing.
Watch out for certification. Quite interesting, the Washington Post, so very reliable source, a few months ago pointed out that there is a sort of greenwashing 2.0. Because companies, they have realized that consumer wants reliability, certification. So what they do is figure out the way of having certifications that are less reliable than they should be. So they're using certification, but it's not grounded.
If we are able to provide the same transparency on impact as we can provide on profit, then we will change the behavior of investors and of companies. How impact, transparency and integrity is necessary for us today if we want to prevent companies and investors from making claims about the impacts they create, which are unjustified.
The idea of having impact weighted accounts, which means that the era of sustainability reports, green reports, diversity reports, social reports, parallel to financial accountings, is finished.
Disagreement and confusion clearly imply the misleading the investors and then also open the possibility better. It is more difficult to understand if there is greenwashing behind or not, and then clearly make it more tempting.
Is to focus on the ingredients, so the indicators that come from standards.
We have to move from oil-based products on products that are used in wastes as a key feedstock for our production.
We need to work together. Together we need to build the circular economy of the future.
There are no measures in place to verify the content of recycling material in a PET bottle. Trust in numbers printed on a label is very likely not the best control.
At the European level, what we are interested by is to create a monitoring system on recycling and recycled content.
Unfair computation should be sanctioned.
Greenwashing isn't a question of green or brown. It's a question of understanding that leadership in the space is about a journey, and about measuring where a company is on that journey is not a simple thing.
We have to distinguish between truth and falsehood.
You bring home some new ideas, some new thoughts, together with a higher awareness about the seriousness of the problem and the necessity of addressing it.